Hello, I'm Mark. Welcome to GOT, good old tech. Today I'm going to talk about the Surface Duo 1 once again, but this time I'm going to talk about what you could do to improve it, or what Microsoft could do to improve this device. Now, I've been talking about the Surface Duo in the last few videos, and we talked about how great and elegant it is. It's an awesome device. It really is. I enjoy using it a lot. However, there are a few things that they could do to improve it. And what I mean they could do, I'm talking about Microsoft. They could do just in software alone, they could make these improvements. And I hope they do in the future on future devices. So we're going to cover just a few of those things. Some of those things we can do today with third-party apps. I'll show you those. So let's get to it. You know, I'm going to start with logging in. You know, on the Surface Duo, like every other phone, you can log in, put a PIN code in. The difference is on the Surface Duo, you can't just enter in the PIN code. You have to enter the enter button. And that bugs me that you have to press enter. You know, it's a nitpick. It's a small thing, but I just don't like it. Also, on the Surface Duo, there's no lift to wake. So if you pick up your phone after it's laying down, whether you have it folded in half or opened up, it doesn't wake up. And neither does double tap. Double tap doesn't work. I would like to have the double tap at least. But at least you can press the button on the side and the Touch ID works and it opens up pretty fast. So that's not bad. You know, when you compare it to something like the Galaxy Z Fold, you can see here when you enter in the code, three codes, and then just one more, it opens right up immediately. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is multiple display apps. You know, on the Surface Duo, you get two displays, and you can play, like when I'm riding my bike, I can do my map, and I can play music. I would like to also have Google Maps running in the background so I can get my turn-by-turn directions or know how far I am. And when you look at the Galaxy Fold, you can put three on there. You can actually put four, but for this video, I only put three. So on the Surface Duo, they should be able to split those two screens. Then we'd have four nice apps. Now, it's not something you do all the time, but it's nice to have. It would be nice to have. So I think on the Surface Duo, they ought to have that, add that feature to split the screens. Another thing that bothers me is the orientation. You know, let's say you spin your phone around, there you are on portrait, then you get to landscape, but it's upside down. So it's not usable. You have to flip it all around, you know, in case you picked it up or opened it the wrong way. I think it's silly. It should be able to do a full 360 no matter what orientation you have. It should get itself straight. So fortunately, there is an app for it, Orientation Control. You can get this app, you can install it, and you can set it up to do exactly that. There's several different orientations. You can actually set up orientations for each individual app if you want to. Say an app doesn't go in the landscape or portrait like you want to, you can do that. Or you could just set it like I do. I just make it rotate everything all the time. And you could stop and start it with this button right here. So once you start it, then you can pick up your device and it doesn't matter which way you turn it. Now it's a little hesitant because of my angle here trying to do an overview. But when you turn around, see there it is upside down, but it went ahead and orientated itself. And then you turn it, is orientated a word? Turn it again and there it is in portrait, back to landscape. There we go. And you can see it works. Just do it again here. You flip it, it turns. And I just always leave that on because if I pick up my device, I want to be able to look at it right away. I don't want to have to be fiddling and spinning it, you know? So I like it that way. And sometimes I might want it upside down so I can plug in the power cord while I'm watching something. And you can't plug it in if the power cord's on the bottom. Here's another thing that some people like to use. It's called a black screen. Now, why would you want to use the black screen? You know, I don't know. Some people want to blacken out one screen. This thing, you can actually move it from one side to the other. so you could blacken out either screen, save battery life maybe. Maybe you're in a car and after a while you want to just shut off one screen. You know, I keep mine plugged in the car, but if you're out and about and you have it fully open for some reason and you want to black one screen, you can do that with this app. And it sets up in your control panel. And this app, you could just go into the app store and pick it out. And you don't want to grab the first one. It's called black screen, but you don't want the first one. You want this one that I've indicated here below. And that's the app you want. The other one is just an app. And you have to open up the app to black screen. This one actually goes into your control panel and you can adjust it from there. So it's just another toggle, which is really nice. When you open up your control panel after you installed it, you're going to have to hit the edit button on your control panel, go all the way down to the bottom, and you'll see it added in there. And you just press and hold it, and then you can drag it on up to the top or wherever you want it located. And then there it is in your control panel all the time. And you can drop it down, and it's better to use two fingers to get the whole control panel down. I didn't do that. And then there it is. Now you got the black screen, and it'll set itself up on the last screen it was on. Now the next thing I want to cover is duplicated apps being open. For example, let's say you want to open up Edge twice. You want to scroll through two different websites. Well, guess what? When you press it again, it just moves it over to the other page. That's silly. I don't quite understand why they did it that way. But if you long press a link in the one app, then you have options and you can open in a new page. And then it opens it up on the other side. Now you have actually the full working browser in both sides. As you can see here, you can browse around on Edge on both sides, do your search, do whatever you want on two different browsers. But the only way to get there is through that long press. I think they should make it a default thing, just like on our computers or anything else. You just hit the app and it opens on either side. You should be able to have two of them open. There's no reason not to. You can see it runs with two open, so I don't understand why it's not embedded in the system, why you have to go a backwards way to do it. That's silly to me. And then auto hide the dock. Okay, this dock is huge, you know, and they can actually make the app smaller. See how six will fit on one side? You should be able to put 12 on there. I don't understand why they're doing it this way, and it should go down and up just like it does on other Android tablets. So maybe one day they'll get there, but until then, there's an app on the side, and you can actually use this app to stack apps on the side. So you've got this little task bar you can open up, and then you have apps available to you when you're using the other two. You have two full pages open, you can still go to other apps. And it's not like a dock where it puts your last known apps down. It'd be nice if it did. It doesn't do that, but you can get all the apps that you routinely open up on the side, so you can just pull them up without closing an app. And inside it, you can see here, you can just add apps to the bar. You don't need to drag it. You just touch the app and it moves over. And you can add that to the bar, which is really nice. And I use it a lot, actually. And there's favorite apps I put on there because I can't put enough on the taskbar. So I add them on there so I can get to them quickly. With that app, you can install it. And you can see here, it's called One Edge. And then once you open the actual app up itself, you can do all kinds of configurations. You can set up, you know, the slide bar to do whatever you want to do. Well, that about brings us to the end of the video. If there's something you didn't see here that you think would help improve the Surface Duo, leave a comment in the chat below and let me know. And I'll bring it up in another video. We'll talk about it maybe some more. Also, if you have any ideas that you'd like to see in the future on videos, whether it's Surface Duo, Fold 4, other devices, electronics, I'm going to be bringing up some other electronics here shortly. I'm going to have a guest on the video here soon, and we're going to talk about things. So if you have any ideas, please share them in the comments below, and I'd be glad to research and maybe bring some more content to you. Again, if you like what you saw, please like this video. Please share it with your friends. And of course, subscribe for more videos in the future. Like I always say, if you haven't already, you've got to try it.